Hey, it's Stephanie here. So I want to talk to you about the value of a client. How much is one client worth to you? So a lot of times we don't know it, okay? But if you really knew how much one client is worth to you, it will really make you think about your business and how you operate much, much differently. So for example, let's say you're charging your clients $249 for their credit analysis, and you're charging $99 a month for services, or on the low end, and then on the high end, maybe $199 a month, okay? So typically they're in your program for about 6 months, so that equates to $600 on the low end or $1,200 on the high end. So ultimately one client is not worth $99 or $199, they're worth $600 or $1,200, okay? And you're gonna provide great service, such great results, they're gonna be so happy that they stay with you, they stay in your program, and possibly even send you some referrals. So depending on your processes and your systems, they should be in your program for an extended period of time. All right, so one client acquired can get you $1,200, why aren't you comfortable spending money in your marketing and making sure that you have all the processes and systems and back-end workflow, everything you need in place to acquire that $1,200 client? So does it make sense to you that you need to spend money to get this client? Since you want this client to what? Spend money with you. It makes sense to me, all right? It makes a whole lot of sense to me. So, you have to market, you have to promote, and you have to invest in your business. That's the way it works, right? So I'm not saying you have to overcomplicate the process. I'm not saying you have to spend a whole lot of money that's not within your budget. But if you're trying to attract people that are gonna pay you without hesitation, that's not gonna be with all the drama, that's not gonna nickel and dime you, that's not gonna harass you, then you need to look like you're spending money on your business, right? Because people spend money and wanna work with you. Right? People that's making money want to work with people that's making money. People want to work with people that are booked and busy. You know, people that are busy and booked and busy want to work with other people that are booked and busy. That's the way it works. Simple. So how are you attracting this client? Think about it. What does your day-to-day look like? Right? What does your marketing look like? What does your presentation look like? Right? Like attracts like. The energy you put in is the energy you put out is the energy you put in. You get back, right? You should be the model because your client is buying the model. Okay? They're buying the model. Just like when you walk into the store and you see the mannequin and it has the outfit all put together, right? And you like the look. You're like, I want that whole look. Plenty of times I've done this. I'm like, I want that. Right? You're not sure how much it costs, but you know that you want that look. You want that final product. You want that final result. You want that outcome. So you want your client to come to you and know that they want to work with you. And that's not going to be possible if you don't have your stuff in order. Simple. Right? So you have to look like you have your step-by-step process, your step-by-step system, right? How you do things, you have to be able to articulate that. Your process should always be the same. It should never change. You've already executed what works, so you're just repeating the same process, right? You have to know what steps they are, how to articulate that to the client so the client knows what they're buying into. So if you want to attract clients that are going to pay you and do the work, then what? You have to invest into your business, and you have to also do the work. Right? And be consistent. Your caliber of client will be attracted by your work ethic. Right? So that's what's going to determine what happens in your business. So what are you putting out? What are their pain points? What are you selling? What are you solving? Are you selling or are you problem solving? Are you problem solving or are you offering features and benefits? Nobody cares about the feature and benefits. Nobody cares about credit repair or the process. They want to know how you can help them acquire what, right? What are their desires? So how much one client is worth to you, you have to decide how much money you're going to go and invest into your business to attract this type of client, right? So many times, there are so many people that are just willing to do the least, right? They just want to free their way to the top. And I keep telling people that you know, free will get you somewhere. Free will help, you know, take classes, take, you know, listen to podcasts, you know, get the information you need, but it'll get you to a certain point, but it won't grow you and it won't scale you and it won't bring in the type of money and legacy that you're trying to create. Okay. So just like you want these clients to invest in you, you also have to invest in you, right? Whatever stage you're at in your business, you have to take a chance on your business. You have to bet on yourself because your business will treat you how you treat it. So you have to treat it accordingly. Okay? So if you like these videos for me, let me know so I can share more with you. I really enjoy doing them. And let me know what you want to know about, and I'll be sure to do a video for you and send it out. I'll definitely be back with more tips, tricks, and strategies that you necessarily didn't ask for, but I'm going to share with you anyway. All right? You know, I'm really on a mission to help you create marketing growth as business.